Hi everyone, Anthony here with Ace's Adventures, and it is good to be back. So, want to say a couple things to you guys, and then as we normally do, talk about the mall that we are at. So first off, before we get into the mall, I just want to apologize to all of my fans for being gone for almost 4 months. Unfortunately, life takes precedent over my YouTube aspirations, and for those of you that follow me on social media, you know that I work in the airport world and also am a DJ, and with summertime and weddings and all that, it has been crazy busy for me. I have not had more than 2 seconds to breathe on my own, pretty much working 60 hours a week and also doing weddings. I have not had as much time as I anticipated to be able to get out and do stuff. Combine that with the fact that now that we are pretty much, you know, back to normal as far as COVID and stuff goes for the most part, people are traveling like crazy. So I have just been very busy with that. Never had any intentions to stop the channel. So I just wanted to take a minute and say welcome back to all of you. And I am glad to be back. And this channel is not going anywhere. As a matter of fact, this is the first video of several new videos coming out on a somewhat normal schedule for me once again every few weeks. So I appreciate all your patience. Welcome to any new subscribers who saw me hanging out with my good buddy Adam the Woo a few months ago and hopped onto my channel here. Welcome, and I hope you enjoy the ride. So once again, it's good to be back, guys, and we are at a mall that I have wanted to visit for quite a while. The only issue with said mall is the fact that it is literally in the middle of nowhere. This is the St. Lawrence Center in Messina, New York. It is a very small town that borders Canada. On my drive up to here from my home, it's pretty crazy because you follow, you know, first you drive over to Syracuse and then you go up the 81, I think it was, and you pretty much parallel Canada all the way up to this mall. And what's interesting about this property is just how isolated it is from other things. There is really not much around it. And in most situations, you would not see a mall of this size in such a remote area. Now, there were some industry and stuff that, you know, led to this place being a popular destination for a while, and we'll get into that in a minute. But this mall, once again, is unique in the fact that it's a rather large mall. It's long. It's not tall, per se. It's just a long strip, kind of like a Z-shaped mall, so to speak, like a lowercase z, kind of. But the idea behind building this property was the fact that it's so close to Canada, and they were reliant upon getting traffic from Canada, which did work for quite a while. So the mall was built in 1990 by the Heritage Company, and at the time when they built it, the people that ran the Messina economy and, you know, the planning board and whatnot, they really thought that they could support it. There was a really strong manufacturing base built around several Alcoa plants, and there was very heavy cross-border shopping from Canadians and then also from the suburb of province, rather, of Cornwall, Ontario, just across the St. Lawrence River. In 1990, the cost of construction was $50 million. In 1995, only 5 years after it was opened, it was sold to the AP Messina Partners. And right away, the mall started to have trouble. So just 5 or 6 years after it opened, it really started to take a downturn. 75% occupancy rate in September of 2003, and the mall was sold again at that time for $3.6 million, holy cow, I can't talk, to the Carlisle Development Group, who hired General Growth Properties to manage it beginning in February of 2004. And there's your first problem after a set of problems is hiring somebody like General Growth Properties, who is one of the long list of mall slumlords who, generally speaking, does not do much with these properties. They have grand ideas, and nothing usually ever comes to fruition. So just to chat a little bit here about the properties that occupied this mall, one of the things that I think is awesome is the mall was originally occupied by Hills until 98. There are not many malls, only two or three that I know of, that were occupied by Hills. If you don't know what Hills is, it was an East Coast chain, just like a Walmart, that never got to the prominence Walmart got to, like Ames and Zehrs and Caldor and Montgomery Ward to some extent, although Ward was more of a full-service store, but along those lines of department stores. Stephen Barry's was there for a couple years from 2002 until 2007, and of course we know how Stephen Barry's was come and gone, really in the blink of an eye if you think about it. And then the town of Messina had attempted to use eminent domain, actually, to replace the Ames and Hills with a Walmart in 2006. But that never happened. And obviously, that probably would have helped the mall from a traffic standpoint, but it did not. So, moving along here, several tenants moved out of the mall in 11 and 12, including TJ Maxx. Sears closed in 14, and they had a hometown store, but that also closed in 17. The mall also had an ice rink that closed in 2016 due to mechanical problems, and ironically, just by the happening of the timing of the video, we're walking up to that arena right now, which you're going to see later on in the video. I talked with the maintenance guys, and they let me walk around. It is now a soccer field and ball hockey and different events they do there, so at least they're keeping it open in some capacity. So the mall continued to tumble downward in 2017 when Payless closed, and the mall really just from that point on, I mean, That's the story. I mean, you guys know what happens to these properties. They just sit and they rot away, and you have it kind of goes through phases where I've said this hundreds of times before, where like the mall starts off as still doing okay for a period, and then it gradually goes down, and then it just starts to, like, you'll lose the security, no longer work there, which is the case here. There's no security on property. There's just two maintenance guys that do the best they can to keep up with it, but as you can see, there are several holes in the ceiling, and it's just the same old story over and over and over again. But again, as I had mentioned, not to beat a dead horse here, but what's really unique about this property is it's a large-ish mall that is really isolated, and it was built for a specific purpose with a specific set of customers in mind, and it never panned out. By the way, as we're walking down towards this former Time Out arcade, the green, which I don't know why they would paint it green, but the green facade there is where the Hills anchor was. It did want to see inside of here. They didn't have the keys for it, unfortunately, but so that's that. So where are we left today? What is the current status of the mall? This place, I came here on a Friday, went on a day off from work, and I saw maybe 10 people the whole time I was in the mall. And the only reason why I saw those 10 people is because the Olympia Sports is going out of business as a chain, and another thing that's going to leave the mall. And you had a handful of people in there looking for bargains. But as we can see by the food court here, there is no place to eat. This place here on the right-hand side, Mickey's Place, I believe it was called, is supposedly open a few times a month, but generally speaking, there is no place to get food, and there is a vacant Wendy's right in front of me here, which I wanted to get to, but unfortunately, the pandemic did it in. The neon sign was still hanging out and stuff till the end, which really sucks, but I did not get to see that in time. It's just, like I said, so far away and so isolated. When I take these long trips, I try to see a number of places in a geographical area, but just didn't pan out. But I got here. I'm glad that I got here. And one other interesting thing, as I believe we're going to pan around here in a minute to see, hopefully I'm not wrong in this, is they have a huge like set of books. Yeah, I am right. And there is a large Amish contingency in this area. And the Amish folks were in here and were picking up some books to read. So that was kind of another unique thing that happens. So once again, it's good to be back. I've missed the interaction with you guys. Hopefully, you know, you guys are still staying engaged with the channel, and I do apologize for being gone so long. The track that you heard, by the way, I just wanted to mention quickly in the opening, is by a guy that does stuff for us. He's Bryce Miller. He has done some of my other work. You probably have recognized his signature sound. And he was tasked with a big project with creating some songs for the new season of Stranger Things. And I was just so moved by the rendition of Journey, the song that he did for Journey, that I had to put in the intro. And that's the level of production you can expect from me going forward, is I want these to continue to feel like a cinematic experience. I don't want it just to be some boring walk through a mall with the same mundane commentary and all that. I want it to be as interesting in some ways and as theatrical a presentation as possible. And sometimes that can be tricky, but I do my best, even trying out some new camera angles and some new panning shots and all that, just to try to give you the best quality possible. So it's good to be back. I missed you all. Hopefully you guys missed me in the videos. I have relinked up with my friends from the DMod, so if any of you are on the Dead Malls at Discord, please go and check me out there. I'm happy to be back with those guys. I missed hanging out and talking to them. I will have a link in the description below to join that. Like, almost all the creators that you know are pretty much a part of that that community. And as we continue this this journey to document these malls, as they fall faster and faster, they are falling and getting demolished like crazy right now. And I missed one, and specifically I want to mention the Landmark Mall is gone in Alexandria, Virginia. I wanted to get there. My good buddy Brandon got there and got some shots and stuff, so thankfully he documented it in some respects. But man, I tell you, they are not messing around with these places anymore. One last place I do want to mention is Northridge Mall may finally be headed for the wrecking ball. I know that there are some ecological, I guess you could call it, challenges with demolishing this mall because of all the asbestos and whatnot in there. But it has been set on fire several times in the past few months, and the city is pissed. The city is really pissed about this. They want this mall to be knocked down and gone. The offshore owners have done nothing with the property and have been just sitting on it collecting taxes like the Kohans and the Moonbeams of the world do. So I don't think Northridge is long for this world. I am going to try to get back there as soon as I can. So enough babbling for me. So great to see you guys again. Enjoy the rest of the video. Here's some pretty dope tunes. Check me out on Instagram at AcesAdventures1. Hopefully you enjoy the content, and I will see you guys back soon with more Mall Adventures.